Hello friends, today we are going to learn the design of C-clamp and offset link. Before starting the design of C-clamp, we will learn some basic terms, that is direct load, eccentric load, what is eccentricity and what is centroidal axis. So let us start. As we know, in practice, the machine components are subjected to two or three types of stresses, and such a combination of stresses is known as the combined stresses. Now our first term is direct load. We are just revise this because you have already learned this in the strength of material, that is direct load. Now when the line of action, coincide with the centroidal axis. Centroidal axis of the machine component, centroidal or neutral axis, we can say centroidal or neutral axis of the machine component, then the load is known as direct load. Direct load. Suppose this is a machine component. And this is the centroidal or neutral axis of this component. And the load P is acting on the machine component. Now see, the line of action of this load is coincide with the neutral axis of this machine component, then this load is known as the direct load. So this is the direct load. If this P is offset from this neutral axis, at that time we can say this load is the eccentric load. So eccentric load when the line of action of load does not coincide with the centroidal axis, or it is a parallel to the centroidal or neutral axis of the machine component, then that eccentric load is known as the, that load is known as the eccentric load. So when the line of action of the load is parallel to neutral axis or centroidal axis, but does not coincide, coincide with neutral axis is known as eccentric load. So in the second figure, Now this P load, this is the neutral axis of this component, and this P load is offset from this neutral axis. So the line of action of this force P or load P is parallel to the neutral axis. Now these two axes are parallel to each other, that means does not coincide. So at that time this P is known as the eccentric load. And the distance between the neutral axis and the axial, the distance between the neutral axis and the load axis is known as eccentricity. Eccentricity, the distance between the neutral axis and load axis. So this distance is eccentricity, and it is denoted by E. It is denoted by small e. Now let us see what types of stresses are induced due to the eccentric loading. That means the effect of this eccentric loading on the machine component. So due to this eccentric loading, two types of stresses induced in the machine component. What are they? First, that is the direct stress, and it is denoted by sigma d, direct, d for direct. Secondly, the component will be subjected to bending stress, and it is denoted by sigma b, b for bending. So due to this eccentric load, we will observe these two stresses in the machine component. One is the direct stress and bending stress. That means this component is subjected to the combined stresses. Now let us take one machine component. This is the neutral axis and the load P acting at a distance E, that is eccentricity. Then this force P acting on the machine component, and E is the distance between the neutral axis and the load axis. So the design procedure for this C-clamp or offset link is first calculate the direct stress, secondly calculate the bending stress, and then combine it, that is the total stress. So our first step will be a direct stress, calculation of the direct stress, that is sigma d. So this magnitude of the direct stress inducing the machine component can be calculated by P upon A, that is load upon the cross sectional area. If the diameter of this component is D, then area will be pi by 4 D square. Now secondly, the bending stress. We will calculate the bending stress by using the standard equation, that is M upon I is equal to sigma B upon Y max. So from this equation we can calculate the sigma B, that is sigma B equal to what? M into Y max upon I. Okay, if you take Y max at denominator, that is I upon Y, then it will become a Z. Z, that means the section modulus. Or we can calculate the sigma B by using this equation, M into Y max equal upon I, where M is the moment, Y max is the distance of the outer fiber from the neutral axis. That means this. If the diameter of component is D, then this Y max will be a D by 2. And this I is the moment of inertia of the component. And sigma B is the bending stress. Now our third step will be the total stress, calculation of the total stress, that is sigma O or sigma T equal to sigma D plus sigma B. That means we will take the summation of these two stresses and calculate the total stress. During design, we have to calculate the dimensions of the component. So by calculating this total stress, we can calculate the dimension of the component. If it is a rectangular in cross section, then we will calculate width and thickness of the component. If it is a circular in cross section, then we will calculate the diameter. So in this way we can design the C clamp or offset link. Now let us take one example of the C clamp. Here the example is given. A C clamp shown in figure carries a load P equal to 25 kN. The cross section of the clamp at XX is a rectangular having width equal to twice thickness. That means the relation in of the width and thickness is given. The allowable stress for clamp material is 100 newton per mm square. Find the dimension B and T. Now here it is a rectangular, so we have to calculate width and thickness. Now the figure is given and some dimensions are given in the figure. That means the eccentricity, the distance between the neutral axis and the load axis is 140 mm. And here the rectangular cross section is given with width B and thickness T, and the relation is given width equal to twice thickness. So let us put the given data. For this example, the load is 25 kN. So convert it into Newton. That is 25 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. Then width equal to twice of thickness. Width is B and thickness is T. So B is equal to 2T. And here the allowable stress, that means the total stress. Allowable stress, that is total stress, sigma O or sigma T, sigma O or sigma t is 100 newton per mm square. Okay, now we have to start our design procedure for the C clamp. Now here the C clamp is subjected to eccentric load, and due to this eccentric load it is subjected to the combined stresses, and that is direct and bending stresses. So the C clamp is subjected to the combined stresses, that is direct stress and bending stress due to eccentric load. Okay, so we will calculate first direct stress, then bending stress, and then addition of these two stresses and calculate B and T. So let us take first step, that is direct stress. Our first step, direct stress. Calculation of the direct stress. So sigma D equal to P upon A. So here P is given 25 into 10 raised to 3 upon what is the area of the rectangular cross section? So B into T. So B into T will be the cross section area of the rectangle. Now the B is 2T. So put the value of B, 25 into 10 raised to 3 upon 2T into T. So by dividing this 2, it will get 12.5 into 10 raised to 3 upon T square. Newton per mm square. This is our first equation in the term of T. Second step is calculate the bending stress by using the standard bending equation, that is M upon I is equal to sigma B upon Y max. So sigma B equal to what? M into Y max upon I. Now for this you can calculate M, Y and I separately, or you can put directly in this equation. So what is M? Force into the offset distance, perpendicular distance of the load. P into E. M is what? P into E into Y max is what? The outer fiber, the distance of the outer fiber from the neutral axis. Now this total is B. So this distance is B by 2. And I for the rectangular cross section, it is 1 by 12. Now this Y axis cut the dimension of B. So B cube. So B cube into T. By simplifying we will get P into E into, now this B will be cancelled, this 12, this become B square, this become 6. So 1 upon 6 into B square into T. Now put the values. P is 25 into 10 raised to 3 into 140 into, now 6 at the denominator, 6 upon b square. Now b square is what? B is 2t, so 2t square, that is 4t square into t. So by calculating we will get, it is 25 into 10 raised to 3. We will keep in term of 10 raised to 3. So 23 into 140 into 6 divided by 4. So we will get 5250. Into 10 raised to 3 upon t cube. This is our second equation, bending stress in the term of t. Now our third step, combine these two stresses. Total stress equal to direct stress plus bending stress. So direct stress 12.5 into 10 raised to 3 upon t square plus sigma b is what? 5250 into 10 raised to 3 upon t cube. Now total stress, that means the allowable stress is 100. So it is 100 equal to, so this equation will get, now multiply by t cube on both sides for simplification. 100 t cube is equal to 12.5 into 10 raised to 3 into t cube upon t square, that means 12.5 into 10 raised to 3 into t plus t cube will be cancelled, so 5250 into 10 raised to 3 will be remaining. So take this right side on the left side, 100 t cube minus 12.5 into 10 raised to 3 into t plus, sorry, minus 5250 into 10 raised to 3 is equal to 0. Now divided by 100 on both sides, t cube minus 12.5 into 10 into t minus 5250 into 10 is equal to 0. So it is t cube minus 125 t minus 5250 is equal to 0. Now by solving this equation we will get value of t. Now you can solve this equation by trial and error method or by using calculator. So by using calculator you have to use follow the following steps, that is you have to take mode, then choose the equation, that is 1, then unknowns, again put mode, that will ask the degree. Now this degree for this equation is 3, so put 3, it will ask the values of A. So for cube it is A, B term is missing, so A equal to 1, B is missing, C is minus 125, and D equal to -5250. Okay, so put A equal to 1, B equal to 0, C equal to -125, and D equal to -5250. We will get the value of T. T equal to 38.56 mm. Another value will be in negative, so we will avoid the negative value because dimensions will not be in a negative. Okay, so round up this thickness on higher side, so T will be 39 mm. You can take also 40 mm. So this thickness of this component is 39, and the width, that is B equal to 2T, so B is 2 into 39, and that is 78 mm. So like this we can find out the dimensions B and T of the C clamp. If in the given example the component having a circular cross section, then this moment of inertia and area will be pi by 4 d square, and this I pi by 64 d raised to 4. And similarly we will use the following steps and calculate the diameter of the component. I hope that this problem, this numerical, understood by everyone. If you have any doubt, please put in the comment box. I will try to explain in deep again. But you watch this video again and again so that your concept will be clear and you can solve, or you are able to solve such type of design of the C clamp offset link. Thank you very much.